Good morning, students. In the last class, we have started your third chapter, that is Adventures of Don Quixote. And students, in the last class, we have already read the first few paragraphs of this chapter. And today I'm going to proceed further. So first of all, let me read out the first and the next few paragraphs. Very early the next morning, the knight and his squire set out on their travels. Don Quixote said, "Friend Sancho, you must know that it has always been custom of knights to conquer islands and put their squires over them as governors. I shall keep up that good custom."
"Thank you, master," said Sancho Panza. Don Quixote felt that he was the most valiant knight in the world. Sancho Panza rode with his knapsack on one side of him and a leather bottle on the other, his feet almost dragging on the ground. His mind was full of hopes of becoming famous. For some time they rode silently, because they were both thinking of a glorious future. After a while, Sancho Panza spoke. "I request you, Sir Knight, be sure to conquer the island you promised me. I wish to govern a large one."
"Well, I am thinking of improving upon that good custom," said Don Quixote.
"What if I should conquer 3 or 4 islands and set up as a master of them all?"
"Nothing would please me better," answered Sancho.
So students, today we shall read up to this only. Now let me give you a summary of these few paragraphs. So students, in the last class we have read that Don Quixote was a farmer earlier, and now he wanted to be a knight. That's why he changed his name from Mr. Quijada to Don. To Don Quixote, and he has also appointed Sancho Panza as his assistant, and now they will start their journey. So both the Sancho Panza and Don Quixote set out on their travel on the next morning. Then on their way, Don Quixote told his assistant that there was a good tradition, a custom, according to which the knights, they always conquer islands and put their squires over them as governors. And Don Quixote, he also wished to keep on that good tradition, because student, Don Quixote thought himself as the most brave knight of the world. That's why he thought that he will travel, he will fight with the evil spirits, evil forces, and after that he will be able to conquer a few lands, and he will set up Sancho Panza as the governor of all those islands. Do you think that he will be able to do so? Let's see what will happen next. After this, both of them, they just keep on traveling. While traveling, Sancho Panza carried his bag on one side of the donkey and his leather bottle on another side. And both of them, means Sancho Panza and Don Quixote, they rode for a few hours very silently, because both of them, they were busy thinking about their glorious future. They thought that
how they will become famous in future and what will they do after becoming famous.
Then suddenly Sancho Panza told Don Quixote that, "Master, please be sure to conquer the island that you have promised me, because I want to be the master of a very large island." And Don Quixote, he also told them that he wished to improve this good custom, as he wanted to conquer not only one island but 3 or 4 islands, and he wished to keep Sancho Panza as the governor, as the master of all those 3 to 4 conquered islands. So students, do you think that Don Quixote will be able to do so? Will he be able to conquer the islands and keep his assistant as the master of all those islands? Well, we don't know the answer. And students, if you want to know the answer, we have to read the story further. And we will see that whether he had succeeded or not in his dreams, we will get to know about it in the next classes, as we are not proceeding further today. Now student, here I have listed out the meanings of the difficult words from the paragraphs that we have read in the last class, and they are: number 1, queer, which means strange or unusual; number 2, adventures, which means an unusual and exciting or daring experience; number 3, knight errant, it means a knight who travels around looking for adventures; number 4, the word is gallantly, and it means in a brave or heroic manner; and number E, a company, which means go somewhere with someone as a companion or escort. So students, this is the end of our today's class, and here is your home assignment for today. And students, if you have any doubt, please let me know in the comment section below. As for now, thank you so much.